What's good, y'all? It's your man's B Phil back again with another trade review for 10/27/22. You know what it do. Let's go. All right, so we're going to go ahead and jump into the Nas 100. Let's check it out. All right, let's go back. And we took one trade yesterday, which resulted in a nice 1-to-1 with 3% risk, y'all. 3% risk. It was kind of an accident trade. Good thing it's a prop firm challenge account, eh? So, yeah. So this is what I was looking at, right? I saw this zone and I was like, ah, okay. It came down and it went came through, but it started rejecting. So in my mind, I was like, okay, well, you know, let's look for a trade. And you know, that's pretty much what we did. So let's go here, right? Now, this trade was pretty risk, to be fair. It was in the zone, and it was a buy stop off of this particular area here. So it was quite risk. And when I was actually looking at this, I was looking at the 1 minute, and I was looking at these candles start to form in a certain way. And what I determined was this candle right here, we came down and then we started to break up and then we pulled back just ever so slightly and I got slipped in to go up. So yeah, as you can see, that was my trade. I will say though, when I'm looking at this, ultimately what should have been it, right? This should have waited, we should have waited for this break and then a retest. But I just had a very odd suspicion as I was looking at this that we were going to go ahead and there was going to be some move to come up here, right? Or very close to it. And it was just price was down almost 1%. And then in my mind, I'm like, okay, well, it doesn't, it when you measure this, right? Would it make sense for it to go back to baseline, right? And I think they say that they call that hyper trading mean reversion. But ultimately, in my mind, I was pretty set on that story. So that's why I decided to do that, right? So it was more so I was a break off of this. It was like very micro. So it broke up and then it had a slight pullback. And I was like, this is pretty risky. Put some padding on this trade, so I put it below this low, and then it tapped me in on a nice little slip, and it ran 1-to-1 with 3% risk. So that was my only trade yesterday, which, by the way, wasn't a trade. Let's put it that way. Definitely was, and I say this is easily a C trade because not every rule is met here. All right, so let's go and check what the remainder of the market did yesterday. See if, yeah, it looks like more recently GBP-JPY just came up into this supply zone here. And price was just moving sideways all day yesterday. I'm sure there's some lower time frame confirmations in here somewhere to get involved, maybe on this spike up somewhere or even this spike up here. If indeed you were looking at it, but I wasn't, so we actually won't even talk about that, y'all. So let's go and check out gold and see what gold did. So gold looks like it fell and it started bleeding a little, moving sideways. So it looks like now today we're coming into this area, there could be a potential trade set up asking to be bought here. As I look at actual price action, I'm looking here, I'm seeing money flow is starting to slightly cross up, but I think it has some room to go up but then dip back down before going back up. So this bias or this zone may be a pretty good zone if we're looking at the different confirmations of what's going to happen. So we'll leave it at that, really. There was no trade from yesterday on that. And the good old, but less and certainly not least Bitcoin. So Bitcoin, we wanted to see it come into this area. It came into this area, it played around sideways, but then ultimately it went down. So there was no trade for me there either. And that's pretty much it. Excuse me. Man, I just wake up and had to get that yawn out after that run. I should be awake. But hey, running out all things, right? Man, this is just slightly sad. Let's go to the 4-H. Oof, look at that, man. Look at that. Just fell off the face of the earth. Said timber, tally ho. Oh boy, yeah, that's pretty crazy. That is pretty crazy. What about Sony? I'm actually curious. Sony's starting to turn around. I mean, maybe that's an overstatement here. Because we had this break, we'd want to see a break above here. Maybe on a lower time frame. I'd say it's just pre-risk. I can see this gap being filled. This gap price come back down there. We already mitigated that. Can I make, I wonder, oh, now that's interesting. Look at that. Okay. Fascinating. So maybe, just maybe, but ultimately, price up. I mean, nah, right? Then finally breaks above, right? And it goes down slightly, breaks lower, and it finally breaks up. So potentially down here, right? We have this gap right there. See price start to do something like this, and then probably Wyckoff or something, and then to go higher. Maybe. Who knows, right? But alas, that's my trade review for 10/27/22. I hope you learned something there. And as always, go ahead and comment, likes, and subscribe. Do all those things as everyone always says. But ultimately, this is my journey to become consistently profitable. And I hope you take some of these videos and go and do your back testing, generate your strategy, document your strategy, trade your strategy over and over to get that pattern recognition, become a consistently profitable trader, just like me. Or as I'm going to be. So, anyways, y'all have a wonderful day. I will talk to y'all later. Peace.